there's one debate that I see which is undermined and undervalued with the Dead Space remake. After the long string of trite nonsense involving bathrooms, faces, trigger warnings, and Kendra's dialogue, there was a more prevalent talking point that was overlooked in the ensuing chaos. If we put the no personality commentary to the side from commentators in bad faith arguments, then we could see the argument clear as day that people made against Motive. Why didn't Motive just do an original sequel involving Dead Space 4 over the remake? I think the first contentious point is realizing how a remake was the easiest decision. Far be it from us to know that going for money is the goal of every singular company. Resident Evil 2 Remake did certainly create a resurgence for horror remakes, and none of that has ever been a bad ideology. I'd rather take a good resurrection that lives up to its name over a cheap, buggy imitation. The blueprint involving the original game was already there for examination, recreation, and an additional content venture that could interlink into a more grandiose story. Taking pieces for rebuilding a 2008 venture certainly wasn't easy. The high bar of expectations couldn't have been more surreal for the company at EA Motive, the Canadian established company that was published in 2015. Motive's core philosophy was listening to the real veterans of Dead Space as they decided upon bringing this game back to the modern masses. That required putting an ear to soul, because, as clearly stated, we know that EA's history involving studio interference was very, very high. This is the very thing that altered design principles for Dead Space 2 and Dead Space 3. The underlying argument was hindering that initial vision from Visceral Games. I still won't say that Visceral didn't have a fate that wasn't equal to a terminal vacuum sucking the studio up for pure liquidation. It's very sad, but also very heavily true. It's not the only case of a herder interference occurred. It was a variety of things involving budget inflation, as we realized how over budget Dead Space 2 was, and sales projection involving sales. Every company has estimates that Dead Space 2 and 3 allegedly missed out on twice. Dead Space 2 was crafted at a lofty $60 million budget, but only sold 4 million in copies, with Project Ragtag's poor internal reception. The beginning of the end drew near for Visceral Games. That didn't stop Ben Walnut from having an idea, from having a basic throughput as to what Dead Space 4 actually was. Dead Space 3 ended on a cliffhanger with the Awakened DLC. Giant Brethren moons emerged from Terra Nova's atmosphere and began slaughtering Earth's population. Isaac and Carver overhear this horror on the radio as the moon then catches attention to their ship, and then the screen fades to black as marker symbols basically accumulate all over it. We have the assumption that multiplanetary stakes are at the main helm for Dead Space 4. It signifies that Isaac and Carver have gone missing from a good bulk of the game. The initial plans included Isaac's girlfriend, Ellie Langford, as the main playable hero. From what we gather, knowing this information, Dead Space 4 involved an interesting apocalyptic scenario. Langford would be trying to survive in a huge empty pit of Dead Space that was crawling to the brim with a necromorph invasion. Food, supplies, and other human life forms served as forms of contact while discovering what exactly happened post-hallucination. It sounded like there was going to be some open world elements as the player would have their own ship. It was intended that ships would be diverse, each with unique purposes, floor plans, and distinctive gameplay. A wide linear style was the focal point that added in further horror elements as you fully felt on your own in space, searching for any sign of life. The ship system required regular and routine maintenance, therefore it seemed like going to other planets was more of a necessary venture than anything else to find parts. Upgrades for Ellie, ship stabilizers, and resources was ripe for the taking as a result. All weapons, systems, and core design philosophies of combat would be re-examined for Dead Space 4 up until this point. Walnut explained a more cryptic detail about the plot itself. I don't want to give away the lore, but I will say that we spent a lot of time working out the origin of the Necromorphs and what purpose humans held in this dark universe. Would players find a way out of the Necromorph apocalypse? I say yes, but they might be sorry they did. Sometimes you're better off with the devil, you know? Isaac apparently was gonna be rediscovered sometime as an emotional stinger at best. He would eventually have a final confrontation on Earth and finally face his destiny with the marker. This was all important to illustrate because Dead Space 4 seemed like an ultimate conclusion to the series than anything else. Think about it for a little bit. Isaac's final destiny, the ultimate battle on Earth, the moon's actually winning in some capacity. The post-apocalyptic event that seemed like a main thematic throughout the entire solar system of Dead Space 4. It felt like this game was the closure of the series, the mainline series, versus actually opening up a new chapter instead. I suspect the reason why Motive didn't do this premise in the first place is because, well, you need to learn how to crawl before you can walk. You need to figure out how to walk before you can run. It goes without saying that the first time that EA Motive worked on a Dead Space title in general was the remake. If we really want to get technical here, no one would really appreciate such a massive undertaking on Dead Space 4. Such a shot in the dark, especially from a fresh, newly inexperienced team that barely worked on the series in the first place. It made more sense from a logical perspective that Motive needed a project that proved their worth while not being too overly ambitious. Consider everything I just read about how grandiose Dead Space 4 actually was. A wide-reaching apocalyptic venture that probably could have took years upon years to fully realize. Motive needed a resolve. They needed a test that wasn't on such an extreme level. Yes, I do think that if the cards are played right, then they could use this time to utilize better gameplay systems before getting to Dead Space 4. If they can remake the whole series at this point, why not? We already have Dead Space 1, then they could remake Dead Space 2, and then they could fix the third game while isolating what exactly happened and went wrong with it. Honestly, even if I like Dead Space 3, you could tell that was the focal point. That was the entryway into noticing how horror was shattered into pieces thematically. Dead Space 3 just became pew pew shooty shooty, which is the same route that Resident Evil took when RE4 came into the limelight. As we conclude this video, it couldn't be easier to remake Dead Space into a household name yet again. So many pieces of the story foundation remain virtually laid out for Motive on a silver platter. After Dead Space Remake hit an overwhelming acclaim amongst the vast majority, I think that at least there will be some trust poured into Motive as new pioneers going forward. I can see a better constructive worry being formulated from people not wanting this studio in particular to be closed just like Visceral Games. Out of all the terrible milquetoast people screaming woke about Dead Space Remake, we can say that another liquidation is actually worrisome. That's actually bad for EA. At least the people who can think clearly would notice this. If EA is smart, they will do what they've been doing all along. heat motive around and give them an approximate amount of money for the development time of Dead Space Remake 2 and 3. Then you could be a little bit more confident than normal and give EA Motive the Dead Space 4 project in order to finally complete the story for everyone that's been wondering what happened to Isaac after Dead Space 3 Awakened. Then you could do some transmedia marketing again if you feel like this could still be a bigger meta series for the better. I won't lie, I do miss things like Dead Space, the animated movies, the comics, and the spin-off games that were a fun waste of time. Even John Carpenter, the maker of the thing himself, said that he wants to do a movie adaptation done right. Give him the keys to the kingdom before it's too late. It's taking the series seriously, for lack of better words. I don't think that EA could afford another visceral erasure. If anything, that would light the entire internet ablaze after giving them trust once. If Motive is shuttered for whatever reason, it's going to be hell on earth. Though we have to consider that EA gave companies and people like Joseph Fares, there's Motive, there's Respawn, they gave them the ability to do what they want, as there is no blemish of microtransactions or underhanded business practices in their single player ventures. Dead Space Remake, Jedi Fallen Order, and A Way Out has done well without any of the usual EA baggage. There's a hot streak to be had here. Will they keep it up? Well, I guess I could say it's just another wait and see affair, as always. And that is the end of the video completed. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe if you really enjoyed it. Let me know what your thoughts are on EA Motive doing the remakes and not jumping into Dead Space 4 as people originally wanted them to do. They wanted them to do something more original in that regard, and I just think that they needed the remakes first so they could learn how to crawl, walk, and run, and then there is the possibility of doing either more remakes or doing Dead Space 4 later in the future. Do you agree with the sentiment? Let me know what you feel, and I will get back to you at my earliest convenience, and that will be it for the video. Enjoyed making this one. I had this on my palette for a while now, and I figured I might as well get around to it and do it as soon as I could, while also uploading my reaction to the Flash official trailer. Check that out as well. I'm Renegade Operative. I'm signing out. Peace, and once again, stay groovy, baby.